43.
All right, we have Dan Ware from the Forestry Division on the phone for us. Dan, thanks so much for joining us once again here on Channel 7. What can you update us with?
Well, right now, the fire is still moving primarily on the east side of the river. The good news, as I'm hearing from my crews, is on the west side of the river, the Corrales side, much of the fire has pretty much stopped spreading, and crews are able to do a lot of mop-up in that area. But, of course, the primary concern right now continues to be the east side of the fire, which is still very active. It looks to be primarily burning along the ground with some limited torching into the trees, again, moving through areas that have been thinned out. But, again, very bosky-type fires, rural-type fires, can be sometimes very hard to access. Crews have to pull into anchor or areas where they can start an anchor point, roads, paths, anything like that, that they can use as an anchor point to start constructing fire line. I don't know what the progress is on constructing line, but, of course, as your viewers have seen all afternoon, a lot of aerial assault. We have several helicopters and a single-engine air tanker making a lot of passes on this fire, dropping retardant and water. The fire doesn't seem to be spreading too much to the north. It's primarily to the east and to the southeast right now.
And Dan, you told us earlier about talking about the air assault. We had four aircraft helping fight this fire, but you told us earlier 15 engines. Has those numbers changed at all?
Not that I'm aware of, but that sort of thing is constantly changing as more resources are made available. So at least 15 engines, if not more at this point. I did get an update, an estimated acreage of about 100 acres. And, of course, again, while these fires are going and it's very smoky, it can be hard to get a good number. But right now, an estimate of about 100 acres if you take all of the areas that are burning into consideration.
Of course, we all remember the Bosque fire from, I believe it was 9 years ago. We were hearing 1,000, 1,200, 1,500. It ended up being like 300 or 400. So we know how difficult it is to estimate acreage in a Bosque fire.
And Dan, you mentioned on the east side that it's still very active. Have more resources been called in from out of the immediate area for this, or is everything under control in terms of number of resources?
You know, I'm not sure where all of the different resources are coming in from. I haven't been updated on which agencies, other than the ones that we've been talking about previously, have been involved. So I can't give you a good number on that yet.
And what about people watching at home who think, okay, there is containment, like you said, it stopped spreading on the Corrales side, the mop-up's underway, but the east side's still active. Who should be concerned, if anyone, about evacuations? What do you want people to know at this point?
Well, really, it looks like the fire is moving on to Sandia Pueblo land on the east side of the river. And so, and we've heard about evacuations to several homes already on the Pueblo. I can't confirm that. But what I would say is if for folks who are at home who are in the area of this fire, they need to be ready to go just in case. Make sure they know where all their family members are. Make sure they've got things that they might need overnight, collected medicine, important financial documents. Have a go kit ready to go just in case this fire makes a run toward their neighborhood.
Okay, and of course, wind a big concern tonight as the hours progress on. Obviously, firefighters are going to do the best they can, I would assume, to work ahead of this because we're hearing the winds are supposed to get bad later on in this evening, towards midnight especially.
That's right, and what fire crews will be doing is getting into areas that could be affected should the winds change, and standing by and trying to set up structure protection in areas where necessary, prepping fire lines to try to stem the spread of the fire in those directions where the winds might be pushing it.
All right. Dan Ware with State Forestry. We appreciate the information. Thank you very much for that update.